is about change, is it not?
Yes.
Most of us spend our lives trying to do everything we absolutely can do in order to keep change from happening. I know in my life, I have spent a good majority of my life trying to keep change from happening. I wasn't going to be a preacher. I wasn't going to go to seminary and do that God thing. That was not what I was going to do. It worked out, didn't it? Yet change still comes, no matter how much we try to resist it. And ironically, we change in order to keep the change that we are so resisting from coming. But it still comes. If there are two things that I believe hold true, it is that change happens. Things change. And control is an illusion. If I were to ask you this morning, how many of you have learned the hard way that control is an illusion, raise your hand. I was going to say, if you haven't, please speak to me. I want to know your secrets. The more you try to control something, I think the more you realize how little control you have, if you have any control at all. People will say, you know, you have control how you react to things. Maybe sometimes, but there are times where I just react and it seemed to be out of my control. And sometimes that's a good thing. For instance, when something swerves out to hit me and I reflexively react, if I had control over it, I probably would have given it thought and hit the thing, right? Like, so sometimes you don't even have control over that. We simply do not have control. Believe it or not, the Holy Week story is about change and about people's reaction to it. There was a time in Jesus's, there was a change in Jesus's tone and mannerisms as he approached Jerusalem, leading some in his group to question whether he was the Messiah at all. In fact, it led even one, if not more, but one that we know of his disciples, to decide to betray Jesus. And that disciple was one of his closest friends. There was a change in the people of Jerusalem, who first hailed Jesus as king during his triumphal entry into the city, but had a change of heart and shouted, "Crucify him! Crucify him!" Only 5 days later. Holy Week is all about change. There can be no doubt that the second Jesus held the Last Supper, was betrayed, was crucified, the lives of the disciples changed forever. They even hid away following Jesus' death, not really sure what to do with that. Not sure exactly what they should do with that change. It wasn't welcome change. It wasn't change they had anticipated. It wasn't change they felt comfortable with. And they weren't even sure where in that change they were. Were they fugitives now, hiding away from the Roman Empire that wanted to kill them too? Were they fishermen who were going back to their lives as they once knew it before Jesus? They weren't sure how to respond to it. What were they now that Jesus was gone, was dead, was buried? How could they possibly go on from here? And we face such change in our community, especially as of late. I can speak for us here at Harmony Hill, that we are going through a season of change. Or, as I said earlier, in the Methodist Church, we call it a season of transition, right? as I will no longer be the pastor here starting in July. That's a big change for a church. It is. You build relationships with your pastor. You trust your pastor. You rely on your pastor. You become friends and family. As I shared earlier this morning, what a glorious day to have that service outside. But that was my last sunrise service in this community. It's hard to even wrap my head around that. I've become so accustomed to being there and to enjoying the wildlife as it happens upon the lake as I'm preaching. Usually I'm hearing about it from other people about, your sermon was great, but boy, those eagles as they were flying overhead were just, I'm going to miss that. I'm going to miss you. And, of course, we know, and if we don't know, I'll be breaking the news to you right now. The Presbyterian Church is going through change and uncertainty. Not really sure what lies in the future for them, but they know whatever the future lies ahead of them, it's not going to be with Pastor Tim. Again, big change. But my brothers and my sisters, we are an Easter people, and we have been shown that change is good. In fact, change is not just good, change is awesome. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. I mean, think about this. If change didn't happen after Jesus died, and the tomb were still filled when Mary and the women showed up at the tomb to anoint Jesus' body, if Jesus' body was still in there, how would we be celebrating this day? How awesome would this day be? It would be the day after the day Jesus died, right? Or 3 days after the day Jesus died. Or two. I don't know, it's kind of odd how that works. But all the same, it wouldn't be something to celebrate, would it? In fact, my guess is, had things not changed that Sunday morning, all we would be doing 2,000 years later, if anything, and that's highly doubtful that we'd be doing anything, but if we did anything, we would be going to some cemetery and laying flowers down in memory of Jesus. But that's not what we do on Easter Sunday, is it? We are an Easter people. The women who visited the tomb were expecting to find it sealed and shut to them that Easter morning, almost 2,000 years ago. But instead, they found it burst open and empty. They were expecting to find a dead corpse, and instead they found the risen Christ. Amen?
Amen.
They expected to be mourning, but instead were proclaiming He is risen joyfully to all the world. Amen?
Amen.
We are an Easter people. Amen?
Amen?
We have witnessed and know that the Lord is risen.
He is risen indeed.
Or amen. We'll go with amen. We have witnessed and know that Jesus is Lord of all creation. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Did you know, by the way, that the word amen literally means so be it? So be it. Your car breaks down while you're in a rush to work? Amen. Right? Someone you loved died? Amen. Jesus is risen from the dead? Amen. Amen. So be it doesn't have to be like a down put, like, you know, offsetting, like, oh, so be it, you know. We can say so be it happily, right? When King said so be it was the law of the land, right? Or if my kids were to be like, if I were like, hey, girls, let's take a trip and have a picnic outside today, and they're like, so be it. That'd be awesome. So we can say so be it different ways, but the word literally means so be it. have this question for you this morning. What do we have to fear? If we remain faithful to Christ, will not Christ remain faithful to us? I want to leave you with the words of Jesus Christ, who said to Martha, as she was rushing out to weep with Jesus over the loss of her brother Lazarus, "I am the resurrection and the life. Anyone who believes in me will live, even after dying. Everyone who lives in me and believes in me will never, ever die." Do you believe this, my brothers and my sisters? Do you believe this? Amen?
Amen.
Okay. I hope you believe this. If not, welcome. This is Easter, and we are celebrating. If you believe this, then rejoice. For things are changing, no doubt. Things are changing. But Christ is Lord. Amen?
Amen.
And whatever change comes, he is risen. Amen?
Amen.
And so are we. My challenge for you this morning and beyond this morning, let your answer to change be amen. So be it. And respond in faith to change, trusting in Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Gracious and loving God, we thank you for this challenge on this glorious Easter. Lord, change is never easy. But it happens with or without us. And even if we'd like to hide away from it, we can't, so it always happens with us. The question is, will we respond to the change in faith and step forward in faith? Or will we be drug along with the change, kicking and screaming, trying to resist the inevitable? Lord, I pray for all here, and for all people anywhere, that they will see change not as a curse, but as an opportunity to move forward and trust fully in your guidance. We pray these things in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Amen.
Amen.
So there are some announcements. The announcements are kind of moved into the inner, one of the folds on the inside of your bulletin there. I'm not going to over-announce any of